Hello and welcome to EQ International Magazine, India's oldest and leading solar media. And today we have Mr. Shantanu Sirsat with us from Growatt. A very warm welcome to EQ, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks a lot.
Okay, so can you just let us know about Growatt, like how it came into the solar industry and it's been how much time like it's been in the solar industry and what are the new technologies you have come up in this area?
Yeah, sure. So basically, Growatt started his business in 2010 with an USD capital of $100 million. And Growatt is concentrated in R&D as well as manufacturing of on-grid inverters, off-grid inverters, as well as storage solutions. So Growatt is having its presence in more than 108 countries worldwide. And majorly, Growatt inverters are widely used in the application of residential rooftop, then commercial and industrial, as well as for the utility. If I'm talking about Indian operations, we entered into the Indian market in the year 2012-13. So now it's more than 9 years that Growatt is having its presence in the Indian market. Totally, we are a team of more than 25 employees, out of which dedicated 15 are only for the after-sales support. And we are having two warehouses. That is, Growatt is the only manufacturer who is having two service centers for Indian operations. One is in Hyderabad, as well as the second one we have started in 2020 in the state of Gujarat. And cumulatively, we carry around 1 megawatt of spare parts, as well as spare inverters for the after sales support.
So what's the target plan for this year? Like 3-4 months are left. So for 2021, as well as for next year, 2022, any new technology you are planning to come up, any new project that has been undertaken?
In 2020, we came up with two different models. One was for the utility segment and the second one for the C&I segment. For utility, we came up with two ratings. One is 250 kilowatt and the second one is 253 kilowatt. The 250 kilowatt inverter comes with 12 number of MPPTs, whereas 253 is the comes with 15 number of MPPTs. So this 253 kilowatt is the only inverter available in the market with highest number of MPPTs as well as the highest rating available in the market right now, as well as the maximum MPPT current that we are offering for this particular inverter is up to 30 amperes. So majorly, most of the modules which are available in the market right now, maybe monopack or bifacial modules, are easily compatible with our inverters. Secondly, for the C&I segment, we have come up with 100 kilowatt and 125 kilowatt inverter. Now, major focus of this inverter is for the C&I segment, and both these inverters are coming up with 10 number of MPPTs, and the 100 kilowatt inverter without degradation can work up to 50 degrees of ambient temperature. Along with that, both these inverters, we are providing the optional feature like anti-PID, then night SVG, as well as AFCI. And for monitoring, yes, our portal is free for 25 years. The end customer doesn't need to pay any additional cost for the monitoring purpose.
So if we talk about the new product as you described, so what's the distribution plan for that, like where we can see and in which states you're planning, or anything plans for export as well?
So if I'm talking about the Indian market, right now we are having four pan-India distributors. The first one is Reddington, then 3S Solutions, Photovoltaic Solar, and AVI Appliances. So all these four distributors are catering for Pan India. And majorly, most of the contribution comes from our distribution segment itself. But along with that, for the key accounts, Growatt is trying to directly get in contact with all these key accounts, where we are also directly supplying the inverters for these major customers.
How you see the Indian solar market, like the challenges and opportunities we can get, because as the government has set few targets, so would that be achievable, or it gonna be opportunity for us, or it gonna be challenge for us?
So the target set by the Indian government is achievable, but yes, at the same time, the solar industry is mainly dependent on all the policies that are undertaken by the government. Now recently, PM Kusum Yojana has started in most of the states. For example, Rajasthan, Gujarat, then Madhya Pradesh is also coming up with, then Telangana and Maharashtra are not far behind, but they will be also coming up with this PM Kusum Yojana, in which majorly the end customers are preferring for the utility inverters, that is 250 kilowatt or 253 kilowatt inverters. If you're talking about challenges, yes, as I already earlier said, that it is majorly policy-driven market, but the overall steps taken by the government are pretty much favorable for the solar industry. So we are hoping that maybe not by 2022, but maybe by 2025, we would be easily achieving this particular target. And also in 2020 and this year also, due to the pandemic, the overall solar industry had slowed down a little bit, but now you can see from the overall response for the REI. So I think that all the end customers as well as the EPCPL players are geared up, and maybe in the coming quarter and next quarter, there will be a great boom.
That's great. Thank you so much, sir. Thanks a lot for being here. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.